I have one secret tool that enables me to do everything I need in order to be a successful freelancer. From managing the projects that I'm working on at the moment, down to every specific task, to just keeping a good relationship with my clients, having all the contact details there, as well as all the documents, contracts, invoices, having an overview of the calendar so I can manage my time on the upcoming weeks and months. And all of these and much more is happening in one specific place. And that place is Notion. I've said it is a secret, but it's not really a secret. I'm a huge fan of Notion and I've spoken about it before in this channel. But today in this video, I want to focus specifically on how I use Notion as a freelancer to manage my business, my client relationships, and the projects that I work on. So this is it. This is my Notion Freelance Project Manager. And this is the page that I use every single day to manage my business as a freelance. To be fully honest with you, this is not exactly the same page just because I need to keep the details of my projects and my clients private because of NDAs and privacy and all of that. But it is exactly the same page. So it has the same features, the same table, same databases. All of it is exactly the same. So before we have an overview, I just want to point out that this is a very simple, very essentials table or template. I know that if I keep it simple, I'll use it, I'll be able to maintain it, and it will have the exact amount of information that I need. So let's have a look. This template is very much project structure. So it's structured around projects. So the main views that I have here at the top are the different projects. Here I have them on a table with the different information, but I like to have it as well as a board. So I know the status of each project, if they are in progress, if they are awaiting feedback. And it's a good way to, if something changes, I can quickly update it. If I want a more minimal look, I can always go to gallery and just have that. The second thing that I have is this projects task. And this is really, really useful for me because at a quick glance, I can see the tasks that I have to do, which project they are related to, the due date and the status. So every time that I go in here every morning, I know the things that I have to do and when they are due. And the good thing is that they are related to specific projects. So as I'll show you in a minute, you can add them here or you can add them from within a project and everything is linked up. Next, we have this timeline here, which again, really useful because very quickly I can see what's coming in the next few weeks or months, which projects I'm working, the deliverables. And it's really good to just manage and organize my personal life because if I want to take holidays, for instance, I know that I can do that if I don't have any project coming up. And finally, here there are some quick links. I don't usually touch the projects or task database because they link up with the different databases on this page. But the bit with clients is really useful because I have all my different clients in one place, the point of contact, the emails, the type of company they are. So for instance, here I can say it's a brand and it's about fashion. I can see the last time I got in touch with them and I can add and delete very quickly. So let's have a look at one of these projects page. Here at the top, I have some generic information, description, the status, and this links to that board that I was showing. So if I change it here and say in progress, when I go to the main page, it will be under board and it will be updated as in progress. Then I have the deadline, which connects with the timeline, the price that I'm getting paid, the client that it relates, and this is tied up with that board, that table that I was showing you with the different clients. So maybe if these weren't Louis Vuitton, I could change it with another one and the information would be quickly replaced. I can add the project type, so maybe change it if I need to or add a new one and it will add here. The days that I'm booked, and here space for documents like invoices or contracts if I need to add them. And here below I have some more information, so maybe the brief or the things that I need to do. Relevant links, like maybe links to a Google Drive folder, a spreadsheet or a Figma file, the scope of work, and what for me is the most essential thing is the tasks that I need to do. So maybe for this project, I need to create a new proposal or a new client presentation, and I can add the due date, the status, and the web. And this relates to the tasks table that I have on that main view. So if I add a new task here, for instance, wireframes for homepage, and say it's due on Monday, it's not started. When I go to my main page, it will be added here. So let's say you are starting a new project. Let's say you have a new client coming up and you need to create one of these pages. I would go here at the top, just say new project, and it would create a new page that it would be immediately added to my projects table. So I can click here and let's add some dummy information. Let's say this is an AR Instagram effect. I'm going to remove this and maybe Instagram effect summer campaign. The initial brief due in May. I'm getting paid 300. It relates to a new client, so it's none of this. I'll have to create a new one. So maybe this is for Lego. And it creates a new page, so it's a lead, it's for Lego, maybe it's michaelscott@lego.com. I got in touch with them today, Michael Scott, cool. And it relates to this project. It is an AR, it is digital design, I'm booked these dates. I'm just making all of this up just so you have a look. Great. So I have this information here. I could say game to AR Instagram effect, anything that it relates to this project and that I think it's useful for me to run it every single day. And the thing that it's important here is that every time that I create a new page, I need to tie this table, this database to this new project. So I need to go into filter, rule, and here what it relates to the project, I need to say AR Instagram effect and remove this one. Save, and I can start adding new projects. So here it will already be related to this project. So maybe I need to sign the contract before Friday. Haven't done it yet. And maybe I need to review the brief and it's due next week and it's in progress. Cool, so now that I've added this new project, this new task, when I go back to my main view, this task will already be here, the sign the contract and review brief related to this project due on Friday and next week and with the status, and this project will be here. So although this looks very simple and very straightforward, for me, it's a great way to work and make sure that everything is connected and whatever I update on one side, it will be automatically updated on another one. Just seeing this view, it kind of makes me feel at peace that I have everything under control and that I can manage my business successfully and know that I'm not missing anything. If you're very familiar with Notion, you already know how easy it is to set up everything, how dynamic, how you can pick up a template and just customize it in any way that you want. And also it is completely free to use. And to keep it even easier, I've linked the template that I'm using down below in the description so you can just download it and use it however you want to run your business. As usual, if you've liked this video, I ask you to like it and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And also comment down below if you are already using Notion or if you have any other question in mind. Thank you so much for watching and see you on the next video.